1,000 NHL games, is a Stanley Cup winner, U.S. Hockey Hall of Famer, and cancer survivor. Please welcome back to the United Center Ice, Chicago's own, Eddie Olczyk. Last year at this time, Eddie Olczyk was in the fight of his life against colon cancer. Tonight, he is back again for the Hockey Fights Cancer Ceremonial Puck Drop. This time, he is cancer-free.
What a moment that was. Eddie O taking the ice again for the final skate in Chicago. And talk about beating the odds. Beating the odds in both hockey and in life. Eddie Olczyk out with a new book. And he's here on NHL Tonight to talk about that. Good friend of the show, Ed Zoe. Hope your summer's going well so far. Tell us a little bit about this new book. Talk about overcoming the odds, life and hockey. Why'd you decide to write this book?
Well, Jameson and EJ, great to be with you, and thanks a lot for having me. I think it was kind of something in the making over the course of the last 4 or 5 years, and I got cold feet, I think. Perry Lefko, who helped me write the book, who I've known for almost 30 years from my days up in Toronto, who's a hockey and horse racing guy, so it was kind of went hand in hand to be able to do the book with him. And I think what has taken place here over the course of the last 18 months or so, Jameson, with being diagnosed with stage 3 colon cancer, I thought that, you know, maybe there's an opportunity here to tell my story, not only with my journey in the great game of hockey, because everything I have I owe to the great game of hockey, but also my battle with colon cancer. And if there's one person that reads the book or hears about the book and I can help them either battle it, see them through it, stay away from it, then it was worth the year and a half of time that both Perry and I put in. So crayons not included, EJ, right? That's for sure.
Well, so. I'm out of luck. Out of luck on that one, I
There's
guess.
Words in it, EJ.
Yeah, words. Yeah. It's going to be tough. Yeah. It's going to be tough. Hey, Eddie, I want to bring you back to the start of your story, because I think it's just, it's something that maybe people overlook now because hockey in the United States has grown so much. Yeah. But coming out of Chicago and to be such a high draft pick and be a part of the Olympic, U.S. Olympic team as, I believe, a 16-year-old in 1984, that in itself is an unbelievable story.
Yeah, it was quite the story, EJ, coming off that miracle on ice, obviously, in 1980. And when I was watching that happen, and look, let's state the facts as I do in the book, that 80 team opened up the doors for guys like myself to be able to get to the greatest league in the world, in my opinion, the National Hockey League, because I think people realized, hey, American-born players can win at the highest level and they can play in the National Hockey League. So we will always owe a great gratitude and the tip of the hockey helmet to that 80 team. And look, when I saw that happen, EJ and Jameson, I thought, man, that would be great to play on that team when I'm old, like 20 or 24. And all of a sudden, I got an invitation when I was 16 years old, made the team as a 16-year-old, and then played in Yugoslavia and Sarajevo in 84 as a 17-year-old, and helped prepare me for the 16 years in the National Hockey League. So, it was an incredible story, an incredible journey, and most people thought it was just a token invitation to try out for the team, but I was very lucky to have great support. And one of those inside stories, Lou Lamoriello, of course, the brains of the New York Islanders now, Mr. Lamoriello at that time was the head coach at Providence College. And he was there as one of the coaches for one of the four teams for the selection team of Team USA in July of 1983. And he picked all the youngest players. He had myself, David A. Jensen, Ally Afraidy. He did take one tough guy in Neil Sheehy, who is an agent right now, and made sure that if any of the older guys were picking on the young guys, Mr. Lamoriello had some toughness on his team. And, you know, that's where kind of our paths crossed over the years. And I was lucky enough to make that team and represent our country in the sporting world. So, yeah, it was pretty surreal, EJ, to live that as a 17-year-old and play in the Olympics.
I want to talk about beating the odds. You talked about the colon cancer. What that journey was like for you and the people that, you know, were in that battle with you. We watched from afar, and I know the hockey world and the hockey community watched from afar and rooted for you every step of the way. And when you guys came on the air that night and gave the all clear, it was just an incredible moment for us. But what was it like, some of maybe the dark days going through that with you and your family?
Yeah, well, Jameson, look, I don't think there's any doubt that when I got diagnosed with stage 3 colon cancer and then realizing that I was going to have 6 months of chemotherapy every 2 weeks for 6 months and come home with it and have a pump and do what most people do that have cancer. When I got a couple of treatments in, I couldn't take the side effects. I was ready to quit. I was ready to bail. I'm sitting there, how am I going to get through the next 3 or 4 treatments? How am I going to get to 5 or 6, let alone get to February 21st at 9 a.m. when hopefully I would be unhooked for the last time? And my wife grabbed me, and it was one of those moments that will stay with me the rest of my life. And that's why the caretakers and caregivers are so important in this battle for people that are in a battle. They may not be going through the physical part, but they are going through a lot mentally and psychologically. I never saw my wife down. I never saw my wife weak. I never saw her worried, but I know that when she wasn't around me, I'm sure she'd let her guard down and wondered what was going to happen with me. But when I said I was done after 2 treatments, my wife looked at me and just pretty much grabbed me and said, look, fight for me, fight for our kids, and fight for all the people that love you. And we had a moment that lasted probably 20 minutes and got very emotional, but I needed that. And it's something that we talk about in the book, that the people that are a part of this were a huge part in my life, because I couldn't have done it by myself. And I meant what I said, Jameson, when I did go public finally and said that we beat this. And I meant that because I had so many people that were with me, whether I knew them or not, and all the texts and the calls. I mean, EJ, you were one of those guys that supported me almost daily. And that was such an important part of this battle, and I'll be forever grateful. So I think that time for me, Jameson, to the heart of your question, was when I was in treatment too. I couldn't handle the side effects, and people out there that know about it know exactly what I'm talking about. And I needed my wife of almost 31 years to set me straight, as she does on a daily basis, whether I'm sick or not. And I'm very lucky to have had that support from my wife and my family.
Eddie, hockey people kind of pride themselves on battling through. Hockey players battle through injuries. Hockey people kind of just battle through the everyday bumps and bruises of life. What's your message to people who are out there that maybe aren't feeling great and are just trying to get through? What's your message to those people and, you know, the idea of like, hey, you got to go and get yourself checked out if you're not feeling well?
Yeah, you got to raise your hand, and it's okay, EJ, right, to tell somebody that you're not feeling good. But, you know, once you do that, I think it becomes a little bit easier. And if you are in that battle, you just have to go day to day. That's all you can do, and set goals for yourself. And that's something that I did, and something we talk about in the book, is where, like I said, I was so worried about getting through the 6 months because I wanted to get through and put it in the rearview mirror. But you have to set goals for yourself. You have to battle. You have to just live day to day. And you know, we hear it a lot in hockey terms, so to speak, when we hear coaches and managers in the National Hockey League tell us that, you know, this player is banged up and he's day to day. Well, in the big picture, aren't we all just day to day? And that's the way you kind of have to approach things, regardless of what you might be, you know, what might battle or what might be ahead for you. But look, I encourage everybody out there, because it was stage 3 colon cancer for me. When I was just turning 51 is when I was diagnosed. The recommended age now across the country is 45, is that you get a colonoscopy. So I would encourage anybody out there that has not done it yet to get a hold of their physician and get in there and get checked out. Because one day, EJ and Jameson, I woke up and I couldn't go to the bathroom. And next thing you know, I'm having a 6-hour surgery, removing 14 inches of my colon and a tumor the size of my fist. So I encourage everybody to get out there and get a colonoscopy. And if you know somebody that is, you know, putting it off, I would encourage them to tell them my story, and to hopefully can light a fire, no pun intended, under their rear end and get them in there and get them checked out, because I would rather have them see them go through that than have to go through what I went through, or anybody else out there that is battling this horrible disease.
Well, the good news, Eddie, is that you look terrific and you're an inspiration to so many that have watched you go through this battle. And we're just glad to see that you're back doing what you love. And which brings me to my last question is, the Hawks made a trade today. So, you know, they made a trade. Alex Nylander comes over from the Buffalo Sabres for Henry Jokiharju. And give me your thoughts on that. What do you know about Nylander? Do you think that he's a fit?
Yeah, I don't know too much about Alex. I played with his dad a long, long time ago. I know that he's a skilled player. You know, he hadn't really played a lot in the National Hockey League in Buffalo, and I think he's only played, what, 18, 19 games. And then Henry Jokiharju, I thought, got off to a really good start last year. Then he went over to the World Championships and spent some time in Rockford in the American Hockey League. So an interesting trade for sure. But, you know, Nylander's a guy that does have some high skill level. He's really good with the puck. And Jokiharju is a guy that I think is, you know, got a taste of the National Hockey League in his first year. And, you know, one of those puck-moving type defensemen. So I think this is one of those, EJ, where you look maybe two or three years down the road and see how it works out for both players. And when you get young guys like this, you want to see them be able to get the opportunity, right? That's the most important part of is a young player is getting that opportunity. And hopefully both of these guys will be able to do that moving forward.
He's in midseason form.
Yes, he is.
Even in the middle of the summer.
Getting like ready for the Travers.
Exactly.
You know? That's right.
Summer
the horse racing season.
Yeah, there is no offseason. Yeah.
Hey,
no schedule.
Guys, before I go, I would like to, I saw the news today of a former teammate of mine that passed away. I know you guys touched on it a little bit earlier, but Greg Johnson suddenly passed here today. And I played with Johnny for a couple of years in the Berg and Pittsburgh back in the mid-90s. So certainly we're thinking about him and his family at this very difficult time. He was a good guy, always had a smile on his face, and just gone way too young. So certainly condolences to the Johnson family and for anybody that knew Johnny.
Yep, our thoughts are very similar here at NHL Network. On a much lighter note, like EJ said, you look great, Edzo.
Yep,
glad to hear
you.
Everything is going well for you. Enjoy the summer, and we look forward to hearing your voice because that means hockey season is right around the corner next year.
All right, guys, keep up the great work. Thanks for having me.